Have you ever thought how ancient clocks were powered? What did they look like? How did they work? Who made them? Join us on a journey into a lost history to uncover five most amazing clocks from the golden age of Arabic science. Today, we rely on all sorts of digital devices to tell the time. And in the not-so-distant past, it was analog and pendulum clocks. But before that, mechanical water clocks were popular. They particularly flourished from around the 9th to the 13th centuries, which was a golden age for science, technology, and innovation across the Arabic-speaking world. This most amazing list covers magnificent clocks that share some key features. 1. They were powered by water. 2. They combined really ancient water clock technology with principles of mechanics. 3. They had intricate moving parts. 4. They were impressive to look at. Let us start the countdown. Number 5. The clock on a diplomatic mission, otherwise known as the Harun clock. This intricate clock traveled from Baghdad to Aachen as a gift, accompanying an emissary sent by the famous caliph Harun al-Rashid to the king of the Franks, Charlemagne. Most certainly made to order by Harun's court men, the clock was made by engineers and craftsmen of the time. But how did it work? Well, it was powered by water and used automata principles. At noon, a weight would drop, leading to the sounding of bells. Then, 12 horsemen would emerge from 12 outlets in the clock, causing astonishment at the court of the king with its novel operation. Number 4. The Ibn al-Haytham clock. This was developed in the 11th century by famous polymath Ibn al-Haytham, who lived for a long time in Egypt and is better known for his groundbreaking discoveries in optics. The uniqueness of this clock was that it was a new invention in that it gave hours and minutes, which no other clock had previously shown. How did it work? The time reading disc was graduated into 24 divisions, calibrated so 1 hour elapses between one division and the next. The marked division on the disc passed by a pointer to tell the time. The disc is mounted on a bearing and shaft that is connected by a rope and pulleys to a sinking cylinder with a hole in its base. As the cylinder, which is designated to sink in 24 hours, sinks vertically into an outer cylindrical tank, the string rotates the disc about its own horizontal axis. Number 3. The Damascus clock. This clock was housed in the ancient city of Damascus in its old quarters. This most impressive clock was originally built over 800 years ago. It was reconstructed by Ridwan al-Sa'ati in the early 13th century. It was so unique because it was probably the size of a room with a large display on the outside wall of the city's biggest mosque. How did it work? It had a lower section with an engine, generating movements and transmitting them by ropes and pulleys to the upper section, causing movement of all other parts. It displayed the time numerically and included two falcons that would automatically throw a copper ball into a vase to mark the passing of an hour. Number 2. A Book of Secrets clock. This was developed in the 11th century by Al-Muradi, who was a famous engineer from Cordoba in southern Spain today. Al-Muradi included descriptions of many clocks and other mechanical devices in his magnificent book, The Book of Secrets. How did it work? All the clocks in the book record the passage of the temporal hours by the movements of automata. The power came from flowing water, and it was transmitted to automata by very sophisticated mechanisms, which included gears and the use of mercury. Number 1. The Masterpiece, the Elephant Clock. This clock was developed more than 800 years ago in the 13th century by an ingenious engineer called Al-Zazari, who was from Diyarbakir in southeastern Turkey today. This unique clock was shaped as an elephant carrying a magnificent tower. The elephant clock not only told the time, but it was a symbol of status, grandeur, and wealth. It incorporated the first mechanical figures, writing time on a disc with moving, time-telling pieces. How did it work? The clock used a bowl as its timer. The bowl would slowly sink into a hidden water tank in the body of the elephant, a principle quite similar to the Gataka, which is an ancient Indian technology. Every half hour, the timer set off a series of dramatic sounds and movements. A ball would roll from the top of the clock and turn an hour dial. while the scribe and his pen would revolve automatically to show the minutes past the hour. As it dropped down, the ball triggered the elephant's driver mount to strike a symbol. As we can see, all those clocks were quite impressive in the way they looked at how they worked. They were powered by water and had some automata principles linked to them. Can you think of other examples of mechanical water clocks that you would add to the most amazing list? Do leave us a comment. If you like this video, like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel and activate the bell icon to get notifications. The details are listed on the screen now.